That this is the magnetic dipole moment and it has three components, say Mx, I, My, J and Mzk. Okay, and by the definition of the magnetic dipole moment, so Mx is equal to I1 into delta Y delta Z. Why? This is the surface delta Y delta Z and this is the current I1. So again, My is equal to I2, delta Z and delta X, and Mz is equal to I3, delta X into delta Y. Okay. Again. The magnetization M, it also have three components, Mx, I, My, J and Mz, and by definition of magnetization Mx is equal to Mx by the volume delta X delta Y delta Z, but Mx is equal to this, Mx is equal to this, this is I1 delta Y delta Z, delta X delta Y delta Z. Okay, so by simplification I can say that I1 by delta X is equal to Mx, so I1 is equal to Mx delta X. Similarly, I2 is equal to My delta Y, I3 is equal to Mz delta Z. Now we find a relation between the magnetization M and the bound current density J. So let us consider two elemental volume one and volume two, consecutive two elemental volume, and the circulating current is I1 in volume 1 and I2 in volume 2. Okay, current I1, current I2, and they are circulating in the anticlockwise direction. So this is the x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. So magnetization along the x-axis, the arrow points towards x-direction, so this is Mx, x component, but it is a function of y because this is the position of y and this is the position of y plus delta y, and the volume r delta v is equal to delta x delta y delta z. This is delta y, this is delta x and this is delta z. Okay, so this is delta z, and this is delta x, and this is delta y. Okay. So, what is the relation between current and the magnetization? So, two elemental volume, one and two. Okay. Currents in currents are I1 and I2 respectively. Okay, so we know that I1 is equal to m of x, which is a function of y, into delta x. Say this is equation 1a. Again, for I2, mx y plus delta y. Okay, y plus delta y. So now we can expand this in Taylor series expansion. So first term is mx is a function of y, and the second term is del mx del y, sorry, this is delta x delta y into delta x 1b. So here we apply by Taylor series expansion. Now you see that I1 at the interface of two blocks, at the interface of two blocks, I1 moves upward direction, I2 moves in the downward direction. So the net current, we want to find the net current. So at the interface of two blocks, the current in the direction is, say this is IZ1 is equal to I1 minus I2. Okay, I1 moves upward, I2 moves downward. So let us use this expression. I1 is mx y delta x minus I2 is mx y plus del mx del y delta y delta x. Delta x and mx and this term will cancel out, so that we have minus del mx del y delta x delta y. say this is equation, say this is equation 2. Okay, this is equation 2. Now let us consider similar elemental volumes 3 and 4 for the magnetization in the y direction. Okay, so the elemental volume, elemental volumes 3 and 4 and the currents are I3 and I4. I3 and I4. Both the currents, this current I3, this current is I4, and both are in the anticlockwise direction. So I3 is equal to M of Y X delta Y. Say this equation is 3A, and I4 is equal to MY X plus delta X delta Y. Now expand this in Taylor series expansion. M of Y, first term is M of YX, second term is del M Y del X delta X. And we neglect all the higher order terms. Now the I4 moves in the upward direction and I3 moves in the downward direction. So the current, so the at the interface of two blocks in the positive z direction is, and this current is called IZ2, this is I4 minus I3, not I3 minus I4, because at the interface I4 moves upward direction and I3 moves downward direction. And if you subtract this using 3A and 3B equation, we can write that del M Y del X delta X delta Y. Say this is equation 4. So the total current in the positive z direction, so the total current in the positive direction is IZ. And this is the bound current, so I write it IB for bound and Z for the Z component is equal to IZ1 plus IZ. IZ1 is del M X del Y delta X delta Y, and IZ2 is del M Y del X delta X delta Y, or del M Y del x del m x del y delta x. Or I widget by this area delta x into delta y. So the current which is passing perpendicular to the surface is delta x delta y, delta x delta y, and the current in the z direction is I B Z, and the X Y plane is perpendicular to the Z plane. So this is simply current density B for bound charge, and this is I Z. And from this we see that del M Y del X minus del M X. Okay, so we have say this equation is 4, 5, 6. Equation is 6, and you know that curl of M is equal to simply I J K. This is del del x, del del y, del del z. The first component is Mx, second is My, third is Mz. Okay. So the z component. Z component of this is equal to Z component is this del M Y del X del Y. So from equation 6, JBZ is equal to curl of M Z component. Okay. And similarly, we can write the other two components. So other two components JBX is equal to and JBY is equal to Y. Okay. So the bound current density JB is equal to JBX I JBY J JBZ. This is equal to curl of M. So that we have the relation curl of M is equal to this. So this is the required relation. Okay.